So we're talking about...
Where to stick it.
Okay.
You're going to teach me where to stick it. I've been carrying the MDV Plus One from Scallywag. It's a great knife. I did a full review on it, but I don't actually know how to use it. And by know how to use it, I don't know actually where to stick it. So I thought, who better to ask than the designer of the MDV Plus One, Mike Don Vito. He actually designed this knife that I'm carrying, and he's gonna come show me where to stick this thing. We should probably use the...
Yeah, I got the trainer.
The trainer? We should probably use the trainer. Safety first. This is the MDV Plus One from Scallywag Tactical. This is how it comes. It comes in a kit with the live blade, a trainer, and two sheaths for it. These are the ones we're carrying. Mike actually customized this one for me, put this grip tape on here, which makes that handle a little more easier to grip without adding any more bulk. But I'm not really a knife guy. I think knives are terrible for self-defense, Mike. So Mike is gonna actually show me. Everyone talks about like, oh, techniques for, you know, we've done a lot of stuff where someone's holding you down, how to fight over a knife, how to wrestle over a knife. Standing stuff, I'm doing pretty good. Mike is actually gonna show me some more stuff on the ground in another video, so make sure you're subscribed. He's gonna show me how to use a knife when you're on bottom, how to use a knife when you're on top, how to stop them from using a knife. We're gonna cover all that in this video series, but I'm like, let's do something fun first.
Yeah, let's set the mood. First off, the fastest draw of a pistol or an edge weapon is to have it in your hand. That's one of the reasons why the sheath is designed that way. So what happens is, if I have to, I can strike. If he grabs me directly in, I can use this to cause some sort of pressure. I can grab him and drive this directly through his eye socket. And then at any point, if I want, I can open this up and then start causing damage.
But causing damage? How? Specifically, what does this stuff do?
All right, so edge weapon here, a lot of people like to slash or cut. First off, if you're gonna do any of that type of motion, you're going to place the blade directly on top and you wanna wrap it all the way around, okay? So I'm not cutting just like this. I'm actually placing the blade on and rolling it as far and deep as possible. That is a decent way to cause trauma, but we like stabbing more than anything else. So if I want to make sure that when he grabs me, he lets go or doesn't have the ability to hold on, what I'm going to do is I'm always checking that other hand. I'm drawing the knife and then I'm stabbing directly through. From that point, I'm going to cause some sort of pressure or counter pressure and then cut all the way as much as possible. Or I'm stabbing directly to the outside and then cutting here. The fact is that when I cut the insides of the forearms, it stops them from closing or rolling their wrists directly out.
On your forearm, I don't know, you have more forearm muscles than me. Why does your forearm have more muscles than mine?
Genetics.
Oh, show here, when he does his hand, you can see that on his. On mine, it doesn't really do that on mine. But if, I guess so, if you're saying if we stop this,
yep,
then this is done.
Yep, so if I cut in and cut all the way directly out, my ability to hold on or clasp is going to be completely restricted. That's what the muscles are designed for. So if he grabs me and I want him to let go, then I'm going to stop him from being able to hold on. So I'm stabbing up. I'm going to get a positive contact as that inserts, and then I'm driving across here. The more he pulls me in or the more I have the ability to hold on to something, it's going to allow me to rotate in. And anytime that you stab, make sure that you grind the blade. So you'll notice that when I stab, I'm also torquing the blade in one direction or the other. So I'm creating a larger gaping wound, and then I cut directly out. And so that's going to make him think about other things than grabbing. And that arm is going to be fairly useless except for just basically a blocking tool.
And that, right? That affects it on a mechanical level.
Yes.
I think we think of... The superficial cuts, like we think like,
yeah, knife fighting,
knife fighting, right? Like, oh, if I just go whoosh, yeah. Yeah, like that sort of thing, and you get me, that if I wasn't all the way committed, that might do something,
right?
But my thinking is, if we're fucking fighting over a knife, we're probably pretty committed to this thing. So cutting that stuff mechanically, it doesn't matter if I'm tough or if I'm mean or if I'm a badass. If you cut that stuff, this doesn't work anymore.
Correct. Stopped him from using his hands, accessing weapons. What if I want to destroy his mobility, just stop him from standing, or allow me to cause more trauma easier because, well, he can't move around. So the thing is that from here, I'm going to be stabbing into his leg, try to stay lower onto the thigh, and as I'm doing that, I'm going to cut directly out or to the inside and around the knee here. So where his knee bends, I want to make sure that the cut starts here. There's less musculature, and as people wear pants, sweats, whatever, the pockets are going to be lined with either keys or a phone, so I don't want to cut over that. I'm getting a positive stab or cut, and then in turn, as I'm cutting, that's usually going to drop them directly to their knee or just restrict their ability to use that leg. So that allows, as I'm stabbing and cutting, his knee would drop to the ground. As that works, then I can start working into other things there. So you don't always have to use the knife in a way that is just going to, well, you don't have to use it in murdery ways, is just what I'm saying.
Murdery ways. The idea of not being so fixated on their face or their chest and like taking these other avenues. But see, I know to target, we do it in training a lot. We go after the hand, we go after the leg, I go into the femoral and stuff like that. But you're doing almost like three different, it's going in, it's turning, and then going around.
Causing as much trauma as possible, the wound's not going to be able to close, he bleeds out more, and I'm destroying his defense, right? So instead of going towards his neck or his face, even if I wanted to do that, his extremities are always going to be able to block, grab, what have you. But if I stop that from doing so, I can get inside, and then now that entire side is...
I can't do this anymore. So, but... when it comes time to deliver the coup de grace, say a person is trying to do great bodily harm or kill you, or they're trying to do that to someone that you are tasked with or have decided to protect, what is the like quickest way to like shut a dude down? Like,
So if you had one area that you knew that you could get to and you needed to end this and you did not care about, well, any of the legal parts. I need his hands and his attention somewhere else other than where the knife's going. So my
where's the knife going?
It doesn't matter where my hands are here. You're just here for the ride. So I'm here, my hands are on top, and then I'm going up directly towards the eyes here.
Yeah.
You know, so from here, I'm gouging. Now, in a real scenario, I would drive that all the way through the eye socket. My fingers wrap underneath. You'll notice that his reaction was his hands came up. As soon as that happens, I'm framing, and then I'm drawing my knife. When I'm drawing my knife here, you'll notice I have it in a, what they call a hammer grip. I step forward, and I'm burying the blade right underneath where the belt buckle would be. Now, it's buried all the way to the hilt, and one of the things about this blade is there's no choil. So what happens is it's a blade that will cut all the way through as I cut down. So my other hand reinforces, and I'm just cutting all the way in. By doing so, it will rip everything in that direction. Even if you had someone of medical personnel right here, they would have a very difficult time putting Humpty Dumpty back together again.
Yikes! Yeah, you can't put a tourniquet on that. Right? Nope. We can't fix that. And it's gonna, I guess that's gonna bleed out fast too.
Yes.
Right? Because there's other places you could damage a person that would cause them to stop eventually. You know what I mean? You see videos all the time of guys taking pretty gnarly shots. 6, 7, 8 of them, and then still fighting, and then they, after the fight's over, the guy takes a couple steps and collapses, but you still had to deal with him for that time. So that one's a little more of a,
yeah, it's quicker, a one shot. You understand that because it is low, as you are causing their hands to come up, they're not going to be able to defend that, right? So I could try to take the blade and put it right over the top, but the thing is his hands are naturally going to be here. I'm going to have to learn how to cut inside and do that type of thing. So as his hands are up or he's thinking about that, it allows me to cut low. And then obviously you can actually add to this from here. So as I cut through and his hands drop, then in turn it will allow me to go up towards the top. You can always add whatever you want on top of that.
And any sort of martial artist should be able to understand that. Yeah. Like that's not a different concept than, it's the same idea and concept applied, just way more murdery. But this stuff doesn't have to just be, I want to, Mike, this is also from Scallywag.
Yep.
They have other stuff. I'll put a link to Scallywag down in the description below. I carry one of these. This is a great knife for concealed carry. This is one of the first knives that I've dealt with that I feel like if you only carried a knife. Like I'm mostly that my idea of a knife is in backup to a firearm. Yeah. But if you were to only carry a knife, that jammy right there. But on my vest, I have this. This is from Scallywag. This here, this jammy here. Yeah. And I suppose all that stuff would be just as bad with that. But, you know, what about this is from Scallywag as well. This is one of my top five most prized possessions, this thing. I don't even want to use it on stuff. Can you give me another one?
Yes.
Give me another one so I can wreck it.
If you can conceal this, conceal this.
That's a video idea, Mike. Coming soon. Concealed machete for self-defense. Yes. But this is also from Scallywag. They got a ton of stuff. I'll put a link to them in the description below. This thing is... you know that weapon guys, they hate when I do this, right?
What's that?
When I twirl it, but I open my hand.
It's straight out of Conan. I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, I do it because it's relaxing and it looks cool. Mm-hmm.